When we talk about well test analysis, we normally mean analysis of well pressure over time. More recently, it's also called a pressure transient analysis. During well test, we create a change in rate by closing or opening the well. At the same time, we monitor flow rate, normally at surface, and pressure, normally downhole. There are two main types of well test, a drawdown and a build-up. The drawdown test is decreasing bottom hole pressure by producing the well at constant rate. A build-up test is increasing bottom hole pressure while the well is shut at surface or downhole. The most reservoir information obtained from a drawdown test can also be obtained from a pressure build-up test, but there are advantages and disadvantages for both of them. The major disadvantage of drawdown is the difficulty of maintaining a constant production rate that will influence quality of acquired data. There are some specific types of tests. One of them is injection or fall-off test, used for injection wells. While the fluid is injected, bottom hole pressure increasing or become constant. Since the wellbore fluid level drops, bottom hole pressure is decreasing. Interference test or pulse test is a multiple wells test. This technique involves two wells, active and observation. They are to establish communication and reservoir parameters between the wells. And finally, gas well tests. They are basically combinations of drawdown and build-up. These are back pressure, isochronal test, modified isochronal test. All of them are aimed to get productivity, absolute open flow on Andersian skin. In broad range of objectives in well testing, they are related to type of the tested well. Namely, different objectives are set for testing of exploration, appraisal or development wells. In exploration wells, first after hydrocarbon existence has been confirmed, we have to estimate fluid nature, initial reservoir pressure and properties. A DHT test is normally run for that purpose. For appraisal wells, reservoir pressure and properties are confirmed. PVT samples may be taken, longer production testing may be involved to check for reservoir limits. And for development wells, the major objectives are to satisfy need for well treatment, interference testing, and current average to find current reservoir pressure. Information obtained from well test analysis may be grouped into two areas. First, well description. We can learn how effective the completion and estimate production potential by means of skin. Second, reservoir description. We learn about average permeability, horizontal and vertical, reservoir heterogeneity, fractures, layering, properties, boundaries, the shapes and distance, pressure, initial and current. To obtain all this information, a special methodology needs to be used for pressure transient analysis. When we perform pressure transient analysis for well testing, we are forced to solve an inverse problem. But this is an inverse problem without a unique solution. The most mathematically fitted solution does not guarantee that this solution is correct. Careful well description, PLT data, geology should be integrated to minimize the non-uniqueness of the solution. The most important recommendation in solving the inverse problem is to carefully select a right interpretation model or models. You have to be able to prove that the selected models are applicable from engineering and geological points of view. Remember, geology is complex, but well test is easy.